how to make candles when the world has ended, the power grid is fried, and nights are darker than your future.
The cities are dead, the street lights are gone, and your flashlight batteries died sometime between the looting and the screaming. You need light. Why? To see the rat stew you're cooking, to keep track of the things stalking you in the dark, or, you know, set the mood for your apocalypse dinner date with a corpse. Solution? DIY wasteland candles.
Step 1. Find some fat. Animal fat, cooking oil, even that jar of bacon grease you swore you'd throw out. Jackpot. Step 2. Melt it down in any junk you've got. A rusty tin can, a hubcap, or the skull of your enemy. Step 3. Drop in a wick. Cotton string, shoelace, maybe the hem of your last clean shirt. Soak it, set it upright, and pray. Light it up. If it smokes, good. It means it's working. If it explodes, congratulations. You just invented apocalypse fireworks.
Here's the science. Fat is basically stored energy. Heat liquefies it, the wick pulls it up, and fire eats it slow. Instant flame. Now you've got light, warmth, and ambiance in your bunker. If your candle lasts the night and doesn't choke you with toxic smoke, congrats, you survived.
But did you know?
How to make Wi-Fi when the towers are dead, the routers are scrap, and your neighbors are busy hunting rats for dinner.
The cities are silent, the internet is gone, and your precious means? Buried with the cloud. You need connection, not for Netflix, but to find out if anyone else is still breathing out there. Solution? Build your own signal from the bones of the old world.
Step 1. Find an old router. Doesn't matter if it's dusty, cracked, or smells like regret, just pry it open. Step 2. Rip the guts out and swap the power with a car battery you stole from an abandoned SUV. Bonus points if it still has blood on it. Step 3. Make an antenna. Copper wire, a coat hanger, even the metal rib of an umbrella will do. Point it toward the tallest ruin you can see or that creepy blinking light on the horizon. If it sparks, good. If it shocks you, even better, means there's juice.
Radio waves don't care about the apocalypse. They just need power and something to bounce off of. Your jury-rigged beast spits out a signal, maybe a kilometer or two if the wind's right. If your phone pings, congrats, you've just dragged Wi-Fi back from the dead. If it connects, well, let's hope it's not just a hacker in the next bunker over. But did you know?
How to make toilet paper when the world has ended, the stores are looted, and leaves start looking like sandpaper.
The cities are silent. Shelves are stripped clean. Gas stations are guarded by lunatics with crossbows. And you're squatting behind a burned out car, praying for mercy and regretting every burrito you ate before civilization imploded. Solution, DIY apocalypse toilet paper. Step 1, grab anything fibrous. Old notebooks, shredded rags, even that banned tee from your ex. Rip it down, soak it in water, puddles, rain barrels, or if you're fancy, actual clean water. Step 2, mash it. With a rock, with your boots, doesn't matter. You're turning memories into pulp.
Step 3. Spread the sludge thin on a flat surface, a board, a car hood, or the back of a stop sign. Let the sun or fire-dried air crisp it into something resembling paper. If it's brittle, congrats. If it crumbles, congrats twice. Now you've invented confetti for your butt.
Fibers bond when water loosens them, then dry together into a sheet. That's literally paper. And in the apocalypse, paper means dignity. If it wipes, congrats, you survived. And if it doesn't, well, you're fertilizing the wasteland anyway.
But did you know?
How to make soap when the world has ended, the rivers are sludge, and you smell like a dumpster fire on legs. And more importantly, why would you need it?
The cities are bones, water's poisoned, power's gone, and you reek bad. Soap isn't just for smelling human again. You've been crawling through the rubble for weeks, and every cut and scrape on your hands is a new opportunity for infection. You need to get clean now. Want to buy soap in the shop?
it's impossible because all the products in the shop were looted on the first day. Solution? DIY apocalypse soap.
Step one, find fat. Any fat. Animal fat, fryer grease, or the mystery goo in a can labeled meat product. Dump it into something that can burn without making you cry, like a rusty pot or the hubcap from a car that probably exploded. Step two, ash from a fire. The darker, the better. Stir it into water until it looks like witch soup. And congrats, you just made lye, the dangerous part. Spill it, and you've invented survival acid. Now mix the lye water with the fat. Boil it, stir it, swear at it. Wait until it thickens into a sticky sludge. Don't eat it unless you want to exfoliate your stomach lining.
Here's the science. The fat breaks down, the lye rearranges it, and boom, you've got saponification. Translation, goo becomes soap. Rub it on your filthy hands, your rotting clothes, or your guilty conscience. If you lather and the smell of death fades a little, congrats, you survived. Cleaner than most.
But did you know?
How to make flashlights when the world has ended, the batteries are dead, and the dark is way hungrier than you.
The cities are black holes. Streetlights snap like broken bones. You're stumbling blind, one hand on the wall, the other clutching a rusty pipe. You don't need Netflix anymore. You need light to make sure the thing breathing behind you isn't real. Solution: build your own flashlight from the junk of the old world.
Step one, find any bulb. Flashlight, car headlight, Christmas tree leftovers, doesn't matter. If it glows, it goes. Step two, jam a battery onto it. Car battery, AA, hell, even a potato with nails if you're desperate. Tape, gum, wire ripped out of a dead radio, electricity doesn't care how ugly it looks. Step three, stick it all inside a tube. PVC, pipe, the hollow leg of a broken mannequin. If it holds shape, it's a flashlight. If it shocks you, congrats, now you're glowing too.
Electricity is just charge moving through metal. Give it power, give it a path, and the filament lights up. Your Frankenlight might sputter, might flicker, might scream in electrical agony, but if the darkness runs from you, congrats, you survived another night. But did you know?
How to make salt when the world has ended, the oceans are poisoned, and more importantly, why would you need it?
The cities are ash. Supermarkets? Picked clean. The last thing to go was the flavor. Canned food is just paste now. MREs are dust, and the only thing left in your spice rack is a rusty thumbtack. You're trying to preserve the last of your scavenged meat, but without salt, it's just a countdown to rot. Solution: DIY apocalypse salt.
Step one, find water. Ocean, puddle, tears from realizing Netflix is gone. Doesn't matter. Just make sure it's salty enough to kill a slug. Step two, pour it into any flat junk you've got. A hubcap, a broken window, even your ex's baking tray. Leave it under the burning sun. Wait until the water runs away, but the crystals stick around. Too dark outside? Fine. Put the pan over a fire. Stir it. Watch the steam escape like your last hope of normal life. Don't breathe it in unless you want lungs that taste like beef jerky. Congrats! Those little white shards left behind? That's salt!
Here's the science. The steam is just H2O. The salt and all the other weird minerals stay behind. They condense at the bottom, creating a gritty crust. You just made your own seasoning. Use it to preserve any meat you obtain, or just to make your gruel taste a little less like despair. If your rationed squirrel jerky finally tastes good, congrats, you survived.
But did you know?